I'm Jaakko. I'm posting in the 2+2 poker forums as Yasu. I'm 25 years old and I come from Finland. These are my friends. Ville, nicknamed Nilster, 22 years old from Finland. Matthias, nicknamed Deuces, 24 years old from Sweden. Hans, nicknamed Nutsflopper, 28 years from Finland. Nick, nicknamed Shipit 19, 25 years from USA. And Henrik, nicknamed Lurkki, 24 years from Sweden. We all make our living from online poker and have decided to live in Bangkok, Thailand. There's probably 100 other professional poker players living here, of which about 30 we know by name. We live in a hotel slash residence right in the middle of Bangkok, known as Scandi Tower in the poker circles. In the long run, the better player always wins in poker, but luck plays a big part in what you make in a day or even a week. What makes us better than others is the ability to handle the swings of high-stakes poker. For most of us, taking a huge loss doesn't feel all that bad. But winning doesn't feel that great either. Losing sessions are a natural part of the game and we wouldn't let one ruin our day. We all started our poker careers being very interested in the game and playing a lot. But by nowadays, especially after moving to Bangkok, we have to force ourselves to play and study the game at least a few hours a day. The games get more competitive all the time, and to keep our edge, we have to keep improving. We spend our time mainly playing pool, playing football, doing go-karting, playing ping-pong, playing Nintendo Wii, playing Battlestar Galactica, bowling, having a massage, having girls over, learning Thai, watching TV, partying at clubs, smoking shisha, dining fine and having sick private parties all around Thailand with high-so Thai celebrities, ex-politicians and rich businessmen. Flipping is something we practice constantly to make sure everybody contributes equally to the community. Instead of sharing the dinner bill or the football court rent, everybody draws a card and the lowest card pays for all. iPhone is quite handy for this. If someone's meal costs significantly more than others, he might have to draw two cards instead of one or pay extra. The other method is to shuffle credit cards. Flipping is also used to determine who will undertake a task that benefits everybody, such as finding and ordering a new board game or making a phone call to book the football court. If two of us want a coffee, a quick game of rock, scissors, paper will be played to decide who will have to get up and get it. This way, no one has to work more than others.